So before I modify this Lotus Elise even further, I am gonna check the compression on all cylinders just to make sure that I don't have any bent valves or a bad cylinder before I invest any more money turboing this thing. So today I'm gonna be showing you how to check the compression on a 2ZZ GE or a Lotus Elise Exige or Celica engine. I'm also gonna be putting in a new set of NGK Iridium spark plugs at the same time, so stay tuned if you wanna learn how to do that. I'm gonna start by using a T30 Torx bit to remove the covers, and then I'm gonna start unplugging all the ignition coils, pulling them out, and unplugging the injectors so they don't spray while I'm cranking. Next step is to take all the spark plugs out. Now it's time to check the compression on all cylinders. I'm just gonna be using this standard compression tester I got from the local Harbor Freight. Gotta choose the correct adapter to screw into the spark plug hole. And this is gonna be the correct one. You hook up the gauge to this one and crank the starter a couple times to see how much compression it makes. Hope for the best. First cylinder, 155. Second cylinder, 152. Third, we are looking at 155. And on the last, we're looking at 156. So compression-wise, the engine appears to be very healthy. All four cylinders are between 152 to 156. That is a very close variance, so compression wise I have nothing to worry about. Looking at the plugs that I pulled out, it's actually nothing too abnormal about it. Rich or lean, nothing really. These are the quality plugs here. They're NGK Iridium, so those are supposed to last pretty long. This car has almost 100,000 miles on it, and I just want to make sure I got them changed out before 100. Has been sputtering here and there at cold starts, but running well otherwise, but we're gonna change them out. I'm gonna be using the same exact kind, BKR6 EIX11, and then we're gonna gap them in a little bit, show you how to do that. So it does look like the plugs I received from this recent supplier are counterfeit. You can usually tell because the lettering is not as bold. It's almost faded and it's very, very thin. Also at the top, there's a indentation on factory iridiums. Very barely tell, but yeah, there's an indentation there and it's very, very subtle on this one. I always stock other plugs at home for other cars, and you could always tell that NGKs have that D
deep dent on top and very bold lettering. So you can also check if you have a real plug, rotating it and comparing it to the original. The stamping is very different. It's less grooved and it's in the wrong location. So Japan, see there's a difference there and the plug's rotated. So someone took a generic plug and just had these things grooved and whatnot. It's not just a production change. I put these plugs on all the time. So beware of who you buy from. And a few other things to look out for. This little angle cut right here, you'll notice is way different than the original one. It's much sharper. And this is a lot longer on the real one. You'll also notice that the lines right here, the black lines, it is a not perfectly straight on this one. There's rough edges on it versus the smooth black lines on the real one. One more thing is there's machine marks over here. It's not just a standard smooth one piece slope compared to this one. See the curve difference over here?
I was gonna use these one step colder plugs anyway. When I do go turbo, it does reduce the chances of misfiring under boost. So I guess we're gonna put them on early.
So I'm gonna be using this tool to measure the gap on the new spark plugs. Those look like from factory, right out of the box, they came out to be about 0.032. And I am gonna gap that a little tighter. I'm gonna go for 0.028 since this car is gonna be boosted. You never wanna over tighten spark plugs since the cylinder head is aluminum, so I'm using a torque wrench by Tecton to torque it down to 13 foot-pounds. Before you put all your tools away, always make sure that it runs and starts and runs just fine. And we are all set. If you found any of this information useful, make sure you smash that like button. And if you like this kind of content, make sure you subscribe to my channel. But for today, this is going to be it. Thank you for watching.